I'm Amanda Rollman. I'm the Professor and Chair in Paediatric Nursing at the University of Queensland and Queensland Children's Hospital. Every day, two children are diagnosed with cancer in Australia, and one of their first major experiences with healthcare is the insertion of a central line. This central line links their bloodstream with the treatments that we have available to them. It's a vital part of their treatment, but it can also result in harm such as infections and blood clots. We consider this to be a very serious problem. And for blood clots, we know that this can cause an occlusion to that vessel that the line is placed in, which can also cause that blood clot to go to other parts of their body. So when a central line isn't being used, we have to lock it with a fluid. It is a tube. We've identified a solution to put into that tube which may prevent infections. This will be placed into their line when they're not receiving other types of treatment like chemotherapy. We'll then follow these children for the next 3 months that they have their central line and measure to see if it has effectively reduced their blood clots and infections. With this grant from Cancer Council Queensland, we will be able to recruit 800 children, so the majority of children who are diagnosed with cancer in Queensland for the next 3 years. And we will be able to fund the important interdisciplinary staff that we need to make this project a success.
My name's Sandy Hayes. I am a professor at the Menzies Health Institute Queensland at Griffith University, and I lead the ECHO trial, which is funded by Cancer Council Queensland. Ovarian cancer is considered the most lethal and least understood of all our gynecological cancers. If through ECHO we can demonstrate that exercise helps women live longer and better, then we will use the findings from this research to ultimately improve standard of cancer care for all women with ovarian cancer, but also women with ovarian cancer are typically diagnosed at stage 2 or higher. Treatment options are associated with a long list of possible treatment-related side effects that may persist well beyond the treatment period. If we are to improve cancer care through exercise therapy for the majority, one of the key things we need to do is to provide evidence of the effect of exercise on survival outcomes, and that's what the Cancer Council Queensland grant is funding. Cancer Council Queensland is dedicated to improving the lives of people diagnosed with cancer, and they do that by supporting cancer treatment and survivorship research, such as my ECHO trial, but also research that is interested in identifying ways in which we can prevent cancer and to detect it early.
My name is Quan Fong. I'm a researcher here at the University of Queensland Thoracic Research Centre, which is sited at the Prince Charles Hospital in Brisbane. Our team has been very fortunate in being one of the recipients of the fantastic grants, the ACCR grant from the Cancer Council Queensland. Our project is to detect early lung cancer that's curable through lung cancer screening for Queenslanders. In Australia, over 12,000 people are affected by lung cancer each year. The problem of lung cancer compared to the other cancer is that it usually presents when the cancer is at a late stage, when the cancer is no longer curable. We aim to change that by bringing forward the diagnosis to an early stage through lung cancer screening when the patient is able to have more successful and curative type treatments. This research will hopefully mean that Queenslanders will have access to a new technology that will save lives through detecting lung cancer earlier. We know that lung cancer screening using CT scans can reduce lung cancer mortality, lung cancer deaths by 20%. Well, the grant has been incredibly important for helping us take this to the next level. We have done some preliminary work, including trials looking at how we can do CT screening in mainstream populations in the cities. Now we want to make sure we reach out to the Indigenous populations, to people in other parts of Queensland who can then benefit from the same technology. It's very important for us that Cancer Council Queensland has been able to support high quality research across a number of fields, including lung cancer. Lung cancer traditionally has been subject to stigma because it's been so associated with smoking. A smoking control is clearly very important for lung cancer, and Cancer Council Queensland has a very active role in this and now is able to help other people who have successfully stopped smoking also achieve better outcomes.
My name is Kiarash Khosrowtehrani. I'm a dermatology professor at the University of Queensland. My project, we call it M3P, it's Melanoma Precision Prognosis Personalized. It's about identifying the survival and predicting the survival of patients with melanoma. Until now, you know, we use essentially characteristics of the tumor that are, you know, its thickness, you know, where it is on the body, the age of the patient, the sex of the patient. So these are some of the key elements that we use. Although this is a good indicator of how patients are going to fare over time, it's still not precise enough. So we want to pinpoint specifically those who are going to have, unfortunately, a metastatic course to be able to treat them as early as possible. This is what our project is about, is to actually use gene expression and use liquid biopsies. Currently in Queensland, most people, thanks to early detection, are identified with very thin melanomas. That means 98% survival at 10 years, 96% at 20 years. The problem with this is those 2% or those 4%. So actually they represent the biggest chunk of melanoma mortality. Having the freedom of that funding provided by ACCR allowed us to access really early technology, which was not available to a lot of other people. So it really get us a massive head start compared to many other places and allowed us to take that risk to actually use the latest technology to apply to patient samples. And without it, we would not have been able to do it.
Hello, my name's Penny Webb and I'm a researcher at QIMR Birkhofer Medical Research Institute. Our research project has a long name, but for short it's called the PROMISE study because we're looking at whether using patient-reported outcome measures or PROMs in cancer care can help improve outcomes for cancer patients. So we started the study because two other studies from America and France had used these online symptom checklists for cancer patients. And they found that by asking patients to fill these checklists out regularly, they could identify problems sooner. And as a result, the patients had better quality of life and eventually better survival. The hope is that the tools would identify problems sooner, which means they can be managed sooner. And then the patients will hopefully have better quality of life, need less additional healthcare, and ultimately have better survival. And also that the tools will be cost effective. When we started thinking about this study, there were lots of different groups working on their own separate tools, and they'd all been trying to get funding but hadn't been successful. So we decided to come together as a group, and that by working together we could hopefully do something better and more consistent across Queensland, and applying for the ACCR grant seemed the ideal way to do that. I've had a number of friends and some family members diagnosed with cancer, so I guess you could say it's become a lot more personal.
Hi, I'm Nicola Waddell. I'm a researcher at QIMR Birkhofer Medical Research Institute.
Hi, I'm Bill Dougal. I'm from QIMR Birkhofer Medical Research Institute.
So the aim of the Lucky Stars program is really to find markers of response to treatment. So this will inform which patients should get immunotherapy in the future. It may start to suggest what combinations of immunotherapy or different treatments should be used for patients. And so we're really trying to improve survival for lung cancer patients.
The idea here is to really approach it in a very deep and broad way to look at other alternative markers that might actually have greater power to predict those responses.
Kind of a holistic approach where we're looking at blood samples. In those blood samples, we're looking at tumor markers, we're looking at protein markers, and then we're modeling the tumor itself and the environment that tumor is sitting in.
We have in fact brought a therapy to, you know, people in the Southeast Queensland area that wasn't something that was available before then, and so we're very excited because so far, you know, the first indications indicate that it's worked quite well.
We applied for the ACCR grant because it was perfect for our groups. It enabled us to bring two very different programs and projects together. We brought people together, we were able to build capability and attract PhD students into the program and other researchers, so it's been fantastic. So I'm a computer scientist, Bill is a cancer biologist. We're working with clinicians who are leading the popcorn trial. We're working with molecular biologists, so it's bringing that network of people together.
We're very grateful for the support of Cancer Council of Queensland. It makes these sort of studies possible.
We're very grateful to the donors and benefactors who provide Cancer Council Queensland the support who in turn are able to support us.
Thank you for supporting Cancer Council Queensland.
Thank you for your continued support of Cancer Council Queensland. Your generosity makes life-saving cancer research possible.